Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. She's an actress, comedian, and best known for her roles in Kevin Hart's Heart of the City on Comedy Central and Ball Don't Lie featuring Ludacris.
This girl is funny. She's truly my sister in comedy. Please welcome comedian Crystal Powell. Come on, Crystal!
Yes, ma'am!
Good to see you.
Well, I got my seat
real comfy.
Now, what was that rope coming out here, honey?
That was I pray on fall. Yeah, let's get that together. You look good. I'm sorry, I'm gonna rub on her a whole lot.
Yeah. Well, that's all right. That's that sister of love you guys have between the two of you. I'm all right with it.
Me too. How you
all
doing?
All right, I'm well, thank you. Well, listen, Crystal, have you always wanted to get into comedy, and have you always been so funny?
I've always been funny. Yeah. It used to get me out of whoopings when I was little.
How about that?
And it wouldn't let me get to stay up late at night, but I didn't know that I wanted to get into comedy.
Mm-mm. How did that happen for you?
Unfortunately, not going to dampen the mood, but it was my mother's gift to me. I lost my mother suddenly. Mm-hmm. She had a massive heart attack very early at 56.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, it was on my birthday.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my.
And my mother is the oldest of a bunch of boys. I got a lot of uncles. And, you know, when you have big families, everybody... Go to mama house. And I just got upset because, you know, I was like, you know what? They've been telling y'all she needed a break.
Right.
Give us some rest.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And my sister, you know, we had a, you know, complication. So I just got mad, packed up my stuff, and moved to California. And that, by saying that's her gift, it's because she would have, I would have never, I'm a Southern girl.
Yeah.
I would have never left my mother, went all the way to Los Angeles, and because I need to touch my mama. Mm-hmm. I need to be, hey, mama, hey.
Exactly.
So when she passed away, I just got upset. I left and
what was your career before comedy?
I was a school teacher.
Yeah.
For 8 days.
Yeah.
I was a school teacher.
You wouldn't have wanted this one teaching your baby.
Not at all. Everybody read out loud for the whole class. You read. But I taught school for 8 days. I was a flight attendant. I even played professional football. Don't let the bundles fool you.
Okay. You.
And there's no greater feeling, of, you know, Kiana can attest to it. When you get off that stage, I feel like I can pick up a Mack truck.
Mm. So, Crystal.
Yes, ma'am.
What was your biggest break? Like, in 2009, when I moved to L.A., we was like, girl,
we was 18, by the way.
Wow. We was hungry and looking crazy in L.A. But what would you consider your biggest break?
Kevin Hart, all day. I have been, you know, on Mondays you send your avails, you email these producers, you're just doing whatever you could do.
Yeah.
And nobody was emailing me back. Mm-hmm. But as soon as I got attached to Kevin Hart, Heartbeat Productions, people from 6 years, oh, you emailed us 6 years ago. What was it that you want? And by the way, can you bring Kevin with you?
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. So that was completely career changing for me. That did it.
For the record, she was one of the only females picked out of Houston to represent Heart of the City. So,
y'all gonna have me acting up here like that. We family. I'm down at the circle.
That's fine. Speaking of family, you know, we here at Sister Circle, we really rally around each other and we support and celebrate each other. Who do you consider to be in your immediate sister circle, your personal sister circle?
My personal, like, Kiana and I, that's why this is... my manager probably like, sit up straight and be serious. But this is so comfortable because we were just in Montreal together.
Yes.
And I was telling the lady back in the green room, like, we were praying before our, and she was going to hair and makeup. I had already, because I was supporting her, and we praying. And I don't cry nice. I got the Viola snot bubble with probably a picture of my mama
the
inside
fences,
the bubble.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Cry. Yeah. Yeah.
So I don't need to cry. And we already talked about it. I was like, no crying in public.
Wow.
Yeah. And so that's my immediate.
And a short answer. How has your success affected your social life? Now, I know the tea. You ain't got to tell the people everything.
I ain't gonna tell the tea, because we ain't got enough sugar for that tea.
Right.
It affects it because every man say they want a strong one.
Yes, they
do. Don't they?
And they want somebody to bring something to the table. Mm-hmm. But if I'm bringing something to the table, guess what comes with that? My opinion.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So in a short answer, they ain't ready. Mm-hmm. They not ready. And it's difficult, but you either got to decide, you know what, I love the women that actually had children first, they got married, and then they went for their career because it's hard to do both of them. Mm-hmm. And you just got to figure out, which one do I really want? But you just got to stand up for what you believe in and say, brother,
Well, you know what? We're going to continue this conversation when we get back. We have more with Crystal Powell. You guys stay with us. My sister in comedy, Crystal Powell.
Yeah. Hey, boo.
Now, listen, we just left Montreal. Yes, and it was amazing. What was that experience like for you?
Life-changing.
Because a lot of people don't know what Montreal is.
Life-changing. And I've been telling comedians, even if you don't get selected to go, put it on the list to get there. Mm-hmm. Because you start, you can see what's reachable, what you can obtain. Mm-hmm. But it's like they said, it's the Super Bowl for comedians.
Yes, biggest names. Like, you don't just mishappily get there. Yeah. You're there because someone know you, they knew who you are.
They see the potential, they see your work.
Yeah.
Your name in them streets.
Yeah, so crazy. So listen, comedians always admire other comedians. Mm-hmm. Who is the one comedian that you fan out about hands down?
Well, just for what she started for us, I'll probably get an arrest warrant when I get by Whoopi Goldberg. Mm-hmm. Love her because they paved the way.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And you know, if it weren't for people like that, Kiana and I wouldn't have a foot to stand on.
Yes.
And so when I get around her, you need somebody to carry your bag. I can do it.
I tie them shoes.
Yeah, I got you, man. My back's strong. Right. I can carry all your bags.
Right.
Yeah. So it'd be Miss Goldberg. Yeah.
So I wonder, what are some of the challenges that you face even when you are trying to come up with new material?
Whether or not now, because of the fact with comedy, now you got to watch what you say. Mm-hmm. So the thoughts that I have and the things that I want to talk about, I just have to worry about, okay, am I going
to
offend someone?
Is
this PC? Or who's going to, what community is going to get upset? And it's no longer just, you say what you feel, because comedians are the people. We say the stuff that regular civilians are thinking.
Yeah.
They just don't want to say it.
Absolutely.
And that's what we're supposed to do. But now,
right.
You got to watch what you say.
Now, I know that you have so much going on. We're on tour. We have so many things. What can we expect from Crystal Powell?
Great things. No.
Right.
Right now, I'm actually working on my own content, because that's the biggest deal, what's going on. You know, if the studios aren't coming for you, I'm going to bring you and show you what I can put out there. So I'm doing Coffee
Smart.
With Crystal. That's what I'm working on right now.
Smart. And also Saturday, we'll be in Columbus, Columbus, Georgia.
Yes. Single in the city.
Yes. So you can catch Crystal and I weekend, Single in the City Comedy Show at the Springer Opera House in Columbus, Georgia.
And the conversations continue at Sister Circle TV.